10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you. And I am Minelli Gabales Tumulang. And this is MM201, Philosophy of Business Management. My topic for today is about Business Process Reengineering by Michael Hammer. To start with, let us first know what are the three important ingredients of the BPR or the Business Process Reengineering, and these are the people, the IT, and the processes of the organization. And now, let us know who is Michael Hammer. Back in 1990, Michael Hammer, a professor of computer science at Massachusetts Institute of Technology. He published an article in Harvard Business Review. Hammer's claims review was first, most of the work being done does not add any value for customers. Number two, work should be removed, not accelerated through automation. Instead, company must consider their processes in order to maximize customer value while minimizing consumption of resources in part of delivery of product and services. To further know about Michael Hammer, please watch this video. And now let us know, what is reengineering? by definition of re-engineering. Re-engineering is a radical change past. Re-engineering is a fundamental rethinking and transformation of an integrated set of business processes. Re-engineering requires not only a redesign of business processes, but concurrent examination and redesign of the information technology that support these processes. Now, let us discuss what is business process re-engineering. Business process re-engineering, or the BPR, is a management approach. It is a methodology to radically redesign core business processes to achieve dramatic improvements in productivity, cycle time, and quality. It is an improvement by means of elevating number one, efficiency, and number two, effectiveness of the processes that exist within and across the organization. The key to BPR, or the business process reengineering, is to business to look at their business processes from a clean state perspective and to best construct processes to improve how they conduct business. The essence of the BPR is to encourage process thinking, shifting from task to focus to process focus, to then removing all processes that do not create value for your customers. There are 7 principles of business process reengineering. Number 1, organize around outcomes, not tasks. Number 2, integrate information processing work into the real work that produces the information. Number 3, identify all processes in an organization and prioritize around redesign urgency. Number 4, treat geographically dispersed resources as though they were centralized. Number 5, link parallel activities in the workflow instead of just integrating their results. Number 6, put decision point where the work is performed and build control into the process. Number 7, captured information once and at the source. There are 4 benefits in employing business process reengineering. Number 1, decrease cost and cycle times. Number 2, increase productivity. Number 3, improve quality and customer service. And lastly, number 4, improve competitive position. There are 4 challenges in employing business process re-engineering. Number 1, decrease employee morale. Number 2, reduce staff or layoffs. Number 3, incomplete impact analysis. And number 4, all or nothing philosophy. And now, let us discuss how to overcome challenges in business process re-engineering. Number 1, focus on all change management impacts, the people, the process, and the system. Number 2, communicate early and often. Number 3, practice continuous improvement. And now, let us discuss how to implement business process re-engineering. Number 1, the company must have a clear vision and objective to success. Number 2, analyze all processes and identify all processes that boost factor to the organization. Number 3, you need to understand and measure. Number 4, the organization must establish IT system and has its IT capabilities. Number 5, you need to design, build, test, and prototype. And number 6, adapt the organization.
The essence of re-engineering. At the heart of re-engineering is the notion of discontinuous thinking, of recognizing and breaking away from the outdated rules and fundamental assumptions that underlie operations. Unless we change these rules, we are merely rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. We cannot achieve breakthroughs in performance by cutting fat or automating existing processes. Rather, we must change old assumptions and shade the rules that made the business underperform in the first place. Merchandising decisions are made at headquarters. These rules of work design are based on assumption about technology, people, and organization goals that no longer hold. Quality, innovation, and service are now more important than cost, growth, and control. A large portion of the population is educated and capable of assuming responsibility, and workers cherish their autonomy and expect to have a say in how the business runs. In engineering, manager breaks loose for outmoded business processes and the design principle underlying them and create new ones.
The following are the videos adapted business process reengineering.
Following are the videos who adapted Business Process Reengineering or the BPR.
When it comes to improving business processes, sometimes all the fine-tuning in the world isn't enough. This Quality Minute looks at how one company improved accuracy, delighted vendors, and reduced costs when they totally re-engineered a traditional accounting process.
We control the quality, the cost, the service, and the speed. Re-engineering, the fundamentals of rethinking and radical redesign of business processes to achieve dramatic improvements in critical, contemporary measures of performance such as cost, quality, service, and speed. In these next several minutes, we will control all that you know and show you the awe and the mystery of the inner mind of re-engineering.
Damn it! My check engine light's back on again!
As the customer provides his information, the service manager is writing the information on the triplicate form. This form also provides an area for the vehicle information. Once the service manager is done with the information gathering, it is then entered into the shop computer system. The form is now placed in line until the technician is ready to inspect the vehicle.
Hey Mark, come in. You can take a look at this car.
The technicians will now inspect the vehicle for any problems. They will write down what was found wrong and give it to the service manager. The service manager takes that information and writes up a quote for the repairs to give to the customer. The service manager needs to contact the customer to get a verbal approval on the work that needs to be done to the vehicle. Once approved, work on the vehicle begins. Parts are ordered, pulled, and given to the technicians. Once the work is finished, the vehicle is road tested and rechecked to make sure all the complaints of the customer has been fulfilled. The vehicle is cleaned, invoice is printed, and the customer is contacted to let him know that the service has been performed to the vehicle. Customer then pays the invoice and picks up the vehicle.
Now let's throw this bloody process away and show you the re-engineered one.
Hey, how's it going?
Pretty good. How are you doing today?
Doing good. I just got problems in my car.
Okay, what's up?
Instead of having the service manager write down the information, everything is done via PDA. This way, all the system's information is already being entered into the shop's computer system. The VIN number will be entered into the device and it will automatically decipher all the vehicle's information.
You okay, cool?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Here you go.
Alright. Need you to...
The service manager will put the vehicle in the schedule, which will notify the technician that there is a call ready for him to look at via PDA. Vehicle information and the problems will also be displayed. The technician will then diagnose the vehicle, entering solutions to the problems, and send the service manager a message letting him know that he has looked at the vehicle and has given a list of the solutions to the problems. Now that the technician has transferred all the information to the service manager, a quote will be displayed in which the service manager will need to contact the customer and get a verbal approval to do the repairs. This is possible since the computer is aware of the VIN and what type of vehicle it is. Once the customer approves the job, the service manager then orders any parts needed that are not in inventory. This is done with a quick press of a bloody button. The rest of this new process will stay the same, considering time will still need to be spent on repairing the vehicles, testing them, and doing a road test. Like the previous process, once the vehicle is done, the customer is contacted for them to come and pick up their vehicle after paying the invoice.
And if you want your car back, you just need to pay us and sign it.
Oh, sign it? Okay, well, I'll go ahead and do that. You know, this
appreciate
is so good.
It.
Yeah, it's great. You know, here you go.
Thank you very much.
There's some cash that I already need, but...
We now give control back to you. Hopefully, re-engineering will work better for you next time.
I hope you enjoy watching my video. Thank you. Bye.